Hello, my friends, and welcome to worship for Sunday, December 18th, 2022. It's Christmas program day. So today you're going to hear our children and youth tell the story of Christmas, the birth of Jesus the Messiah. They did it in lots of different ways, in their homes, in their pajamas, with their dogs, in front of Christmas trees, all kinds of things. So I recorded my part of the video the same way, on my phone in front of this lovely tree at St. John's in Black Creek. I'm not going to say much more today except to remind you that Christmas Eve worship is on Saturday at Cecil at 3 o'clock, Trinity at 5 o'clock, and Black Creek at 7 o'clock. All three services include candles, carols, communion, and scripture to welcome the newborn Jesus. And to remind you that there is no worship at any of our parish churches on Sunday, December 25th, or at Cecil on Sunday, January 1st, though Trinity and Black Creek will both have New Year's Day worship. So please sit back, listen, and enjoy some carols and the telling of this timeless story in a new way. May God bless your day.
Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strain. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Chelsea's day, shepherds, why this jubilee? Why your joyous strains prolong? What the gladsome tidings be, which inspire your heavenly song? Adore on bended knee, Christ the Lord, the newborn King. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Thank you. Chelsea's day.
Hear what God promised us. The people that walk in the darkness will see the great light. And the people that live in the deepest darkness, and then light will shine for a child has been born. And a son given to us, and he is named
Wonderful Counselor, Almighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
His influence will grow, and there will be peace for the people of David and his kingdom. He will create justice from now and forever.
In the beginning was a Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. What has come into being in him with life? And the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome it.
And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. From his fullness, we have all received grace upon grace. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to God's heart, who has made him known.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to the town of Galilee, called Nazareth, to a woman engaged to a man whose name was Joseph. He was from the family of David. The woman's name was Mary. The angel said to her,
"Greetings, blessed one. The Lord is with you."
But she was very confused by these words and wondered what this might mean. The angel said to her,
"Do not be afraid, Mary. God is pleased with you."
The angel continued, "You will conceive and have a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever. The kingdom will never end," Mary said to the angel.
"How can this be?"
The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit, the power of God, will come to you, and the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God, and your cousin Elizabeth is also having a son. She's in her sixth month, and even though she was said to be unable to have children, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said,
"I am here, the servant of the Lord."
In those days, Mary went quickly to the town in the hills. She went in and greeted her cousin Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard of Mary, the child inside her jumped. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She stand out loud saying, "Blessed are you among women. Blessed this is the child in you. Why has this happened that the mother of my Lord comes to me? As soon as I heard your voice, the child inside me jumped for joy. Blessed is she who believed that what God said would come true."
My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For God has looked with favor on the humbleness of this servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed. For God has done great things for me. And holy is God's name. God's mercy is for those who worship God. From generation to generation, God has shown strength with their arm. God has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their heart. God has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. God has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. God has helped the servant Israel in remembrance of mercy, according to the promise made to our ancestors, to Abraham and Sarah, and their descendants forever.
In those days, an order went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everyone went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph was from the house and family of David. He went to Nazareth to the city of David called Bethlehem. He went with Mary, to whom was he engaged, and who was he expecting? A child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver the child. She gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them to lie in the inn.
And that place there were shepherds living in the fields, watching over their sheep. An angel from the God came and stood in front of them. They were scared, but the angel said, "Do not be afraid, and I bring good news of great joy. Today in the city of David, a baby has been born. He is the Messiah, the Christ, the Lord. You will find the child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in the manger."
And there was with the angel a whole chorus of angels singing and praising God, saying,
"Glories to God in the highest heavens, and on earth peace
among all people."
Peace among all people.
Then the angels left and went back to heaven, and the shepherds said to each other, Let us go to Bethlehem and see what happened. And the angels told us about. So they went quickly and found Mary and Joseph, the child laying in the manger. When they saw the baby, they told Mary and Joseph what the angels had said. Everyone was amazed. And then the shepherds went back to the fields, singing and praising to God.
In Jerusalem, when Herod was the king, and after Jesus was born, wise men came from the east asking,
Where is the child who was born king of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising. We have come to worship him.
When King Herod heard this, he was afraid, and all the other people in Jerusalem were afraid too. He called together his advisors and priests and teachers and asked them where the Messiah was supposed to be born. They told him,
In Bethlehem, just like the prophet said, from you, Bethlehem, will come a ruler who will shepherd my people.
Then Herod called for the wise men in a secret. He asked them exactly when the star they followed had appeared. They sent them to Bethlehem and said,
"Go and search for the child. When you have found him, come back to me and tell me where he is so I can go and worship him."
The wise men followed the star.
It stopped over the place where the baby was.
They were filled with joy.
Then they went inside and saw the baby with his mom Mary.
They opened the present and they gave him gold, frankincense,
and
then they went home on a different road.